my joy to share with you a message about tapping into your higher power. There was a pastor who was reviewing Christian history during his sermon. He was talking about powerful kings and queens, and then he asked rhetorically, "But there is a higher power, isn't there?" And the little girl blurted out, "I know, aces!"
Okay.
Today I want to share about what it means to have a higher power, some practical ways to tap into that power, and how tapping that relationship gets us connected and gives us the serenity and the power that we need for our journeys. Let us pray. God, grant me the serenity to accept the things I cannot change, the courage to change the things I can, and the wisdom to know the difference. Amen.
Amen.
So first, and I have to say, most of what I am saying in this next section of the message was stolen directly from two Alcoholics Anonymous sites with some of my own commentary thrown in. Put simply, your own personal higher power is a force for good that is something bigger than and outside of yourself. For most of you here today, we call that higher power God. But what you call God is not nearly as important as that you call God. And there are people out there because they have been hit over the head with religion or hurt deeply by religion, are not at that point yet where they can name their higher power and call that God. And that's okay. We know God by many names. Higher power is not one that's going to offend God. Amen?
Amen.
And so that's why in AA and NA, they just say higher power, in order to meet people where they were at, where they're at. Sort of like Jesus does, right? Meets us where we're at. That's what Jesus did in his earthly life. He met people where they were at. He didn't tell them, you know, you need to clean up your life and get right with God, and then you can go to church. I was talking to someone yesterday, and he said, you know, when I invited him to church, and he said, "Well, I've just got to clean up my act." And I said, "Well, don't wait to clean up your act to come to church." That's besides the point. There are several advantages to tapping into a higher power. It lets you feel connected. Connected. You are not alone in your struggles. It helps you to be calm and emotionally still when you're facing those difficulties. Is it going to be perfect? No. Because sometimes we take over, don't we? And we depend, and we worry, because God doesn't have any pain, right? Because our worrying is going to make it a lot better. But it allows you to free yourself of that notion that you are in control. And I have to say, that last advantage, freedom from the illusion of control, is the biggest benefit that you can realize when you're able to connect to God and your higher power. Because we think we're in control, right? Yeah. Addicts and alcoholics, and so many of us, live our lives with the mistaken idea that we can control things that, quite frankly, are not at all under our control. Other people's reactions. The future. And, of course, drinking or drugging or other addictive behaviors. The only thing that we can control is our own actions and our own attitude. That we can control. You know, the Christian religion would not be nearly as unpopular as it is today if we remembered that simple thing. That we're only responsible for controlling our own attitude and actions. If we concentrate on that, the world will come running to us. But we often fail miserably. We all do. I do. I want you to know that people can get addicted to religion. And they come under the illusion that they can control things because they think their way of thinking about God is exactly right. But our spirituality should not be about getting, but about letting go. Letting go of trying to control things. Sometimes letting go of things. Right?
Right.
When we tap into our higher power, we're able to change the things in our lives that we can. And give up or accept those that are beyond our control. We free ourselves of the responsibility and the stress, the burden of vainly trying to exert control when we have none. In other words, we become ready to receive the help that we need. Now, I can't say this often enough. Everyone needs help. Amen?
Amen.
Repeat that with me. Everyone needs help. Including me.
Including you.
Yes, I do. If we could just learn to ask for help when we need it. Let me tell you, there would be far less emergency room visits, heart attacks, and need for psychiatric medications. When people just learn to ask help when it first comes up, when they need help. Those are some of the benefits of tapping into God, our higher power. Second, here are some how-to tips for tapping into your higher power. And remember, there's no one right way to do this. Your relationship with God, our higher power, is highly personal and unique to your own experience. But here are some things that you can do that will make it easier to connect with the divine. Keep an open mind. Top of the list. Cynicism, skepticism, and stubbornness serve you poorly during your recovery. And we are all recovering from something in life, right?
Yeah.
Keep an open mind. Learn to pray. This is important. It doesn't matter if you're agnostic or atheist. You still have a need to pray. Praying lets you truly express what's on your mind. Your daily struggles, your triumphs, your failures, your hopes, your questions. Think of prayer as your way of talking to the universe. How do you talk to God? Well, you just talk out loud. As you would talk to a friend or a family member that was really willing to listen. In other words, you don't have to couch your terms. You don't have to be careful about what words you use. You're just sharing. That's a powerful thing. And sometimes we need to hear our own words out loud to realize just how ridiculous we are. No special words or language required. Practice meditation. Learning to focus your attention inward allows you to be truly aware of where you are in the moment, physically, emotionally, mentally, spiritually, so that you can make those adjustments that you need to make. So if prayer is talking, meditation is listening. Listening to the universe because it is talking to you. God is always talking to us if we're willing to listen. We need to spend a lot more time listening. Help other people. This goes back to feeling a connection. And I have to tell you here, there are some people who are addicted to self-giving. And that is not a good thing. If you are addicted to self-giving to the point that you continually exhaust yourself, then you're not doing it right. Some of us fall into that category. But helping other people connects us. It brings us closer to God because we're able to draw strength and inspiration from that closeness that we have with other people. Continue to look for new ways of understanding. No matter how earnestly you search, it is impossible for you to completely know and understand God, your higher power. and hence the term greater than yourself, right? Mm. We never get to that point where we've got it all figured out. If you're there, you gotta come talk to me. Because you've got a God complex. We will never achieve perfection in the sense of having all of our questions answered, but we can always continually move forward and improve ourselves and ask new questions and learn to love the journey. Finally, third, tapping that relationship with God, the higher power, gets us connected and gives us the serenity and the power that we need for our journey. And the wisdom that I share here comes adapted from Sister Joan Chittister. She is a wonderful Catholic rebel monk sister. On the evening before his crucifixion, Jesus prayed. Jesus prays that the disciples will come to know God in a personal way. And actually, Jesus is simply echoing those words of Moses, restating the lines in a brief phrase, that they may know you, the only one true God. And Jesus isn't talking about knowing God like you know your ABCs. Right? You can memorize your ABCs. We learned to do that when we're little kids. When your loved one tells you that he or she wants to know you better, they don't mean things like your shoe size. Right? When a loved one or someone that loves you wants to get to know you better, they're talking about intimacy, getting to know you personally. You could memorize the entire Bible and follow all the rules of Christianity, but that's not going to get you tapped into the power that you need. Jesus is praying for you so that you can get to know him personally. For many, it's a hard thing to do. Because, well, think about it for a minute. Think how hard it is to let our family, a friend, or a loved one even, into the door of our heart. It's hard for many of us because we've been hurt. So, most people practice that same kind of reserve, that same kind of closed door attitude with God. And if you do that with God, you're not going to get anywhere because God can't get in. God doesn't batter down the door of your heart. God waits for you to say, please, would you come in? Relationships are give and take. It's the same with your relationship with your higher power. You've got to have some give and take. You've got to pray and you've got to listen. It's the way we find meaning in life, and it's the way that we grow as human beings. Anyone who is genuinely happy has found a way to do this. Awareness is the first mark of your success in tapping into this higher power. You become aware acutely of the world. You have this sense of wonder. The awesomeness of life. We in this country have been taught false dualism. It's a worldview that does not serve us well. It's a worldview that separates spirit and matter. That's a false dualism. It's a worldview that separates reason and feeling. It's a false dualism. It separates light and dark. It makes us think that everything is black or white, right or wrong. Life is not split into two substances, one spirit and one matter. It's a very Greek way of thinking, and it's kind of popular in Jesus' day, but Jesus didn't have anything of that. Life is a complex and seamless web where everything is connected. Matter and spirit are connected, joined together on the tether of a fragile human life. Life is one creation, integrated and brimming with the divine. And that's why some religious people are so uncomfortable with a human Jesus. They are. They don't like it when the risen Jesus says, see these hands, look at these feet, touch these wounds. That's way too personal, too physical for us. And if that makes you, then you need to get in touch with that physical side of your spirituality. The risen Christ manifests all of our humanness and godness as well. The magnitude of which I have not seen nor ear heard. And yet, we can tap into that power. We get glimpses of it. For us as people of God, Christians or people of a higher power, the entire world is sacramental. That's living your life as a prayer. When you see the entire world as holy, including those whose eyes you look into, because they are. God is there. A follower of Jesus is necessarily a naturalist, a lover of life, a respecter of persons, a diviner of the tangible, who seeks to peer deeply into the creation and discover the Creator. Who seeks to peer deeply into God's created ones, God's children, to discover the Creator present in each of us. Dailiness, ordinariness, is the stuff of contemplation. And when we peer deeply, we become awed at God's magnificence. It is nothing ordinary. As Joan says, the contemplative does not go looking into the stars to discover God. The contemplative sees God in the clutter of the day. Here, in the struggles of marriage and employment and dissension and jealousies and rejection and the broken shards of trust, the contemplative sees the Jesus who shows you the way beyond these things to the ascension. Beyond suffering to the glory of holiness. Jesus came to be among us. He walked with us and blessed the earth. Jesus lived the life that we live. He grew in wisdom and in stature and grace and made it even easier for us to do so. Jesus raises our eyes above and beyond the narrow limit of our own paltry lives and shows us there are other horizons. Outside of ourselves.
Amen.
Right?
Amen.
That's the key. Outside of ourselves. In the end, out of the dregs of the worst the world has to offer, God, our higher power, lifts our eyes and our souls to the vision that transcends the pedestrian, the ordinary. Jesus ascended into heaven. Jesus' ascension brings us face to face with the mystical and reminds us to pay attention to all that God gives us while we walk this world, for there is more to come. We can, if we look hard enough at everything that is right in front of us, find out. We don't need aces or cards up our sleeves to tap into our higher power.
Amen.